Are you gonna behave? Feline in a funk? There's a cat app for that. A weather forecast that lets you feel tomorrow's temperatures today and completely immersive tours. I'm Callie Lewis. Welcome to Geek Beat number 407. This episode of Geek Beat TV is brought to you by The Ben Heck Show. The Live Park 4D Art Factory, that's right, 4D, in South Korea is taking exhibit tours to the extreme. They're strapping RFID sensor-enabled wristbands onto people. There are a bunch of Kinect sensors around the place to distinguish their movements, their faces, and voices as they wander through a 10,000 square foot virtual amusement park. Each visitor is assigned an avatar, which reacts to their movements as they tour 65 different attractions. They can interact with holograms and other stuff. The Live Park 4D Art Factory is only a temporary exhibit, but with all the positive reactions, we're told that permanent versions are being considered for construction in China and Singapore. Guess I'm going to Singapore. It's one thing to hear or read tomorrow's high and low temperatures, and another to actually feel it, which is where the haptic cube comes in. The inventor calls this aluminum-skinned gadget the cryoscope. It contains a powerful thermoelectric element that can heat the cube up to 100 degrees or down to zero. That's cold enough to freeze water and hot enough to melt ice, but it's still a working concept device, so not available in stores just yet, unfortunately. And of course, you'll only get temperatures for your zip code. Memo to designer, please lose the rainbow-colored ribbon cable, but I kinda dig how your socks match. I imagine that this guy had an idea in his head and started tinkering until he got something working. I love when people do that. And with Valentine's Day around the corner, why not tinker with a candy heart that changes messages through Twitter so you can tell your loved one just how much you care? Ben Heck did just that. You can watch new episodes every 2 weeks at revision3.com/TBHS. He's always doing fun stuff like that. And you can even take home the mods at element14.com/TBHS. A lot of people make the decision, for one reason or another, to keep their cats indoors. And to make up for the lack of ability to climb trees, Dave is giving me the look like we're doing cats, really? Seriously? But this is cool, Dave, don't worry. To make up for the lack of ability to climb trees, they build cardboard houses. Well, an Australian SPCA says that your companion needs more stimulation, so they've released the Affection Collection for your tabby's tablet on iTunes. All right, so you've probably seen videos of cats playing people apps, you know, tapping at the iPad, but this free cat app actually features three games, Kitty Raid, Roller Kitty, and Kitty Chef, designed just for cats. And the early reviews are perfect. Perfect. The SPCA of Queensland swears that one satisfied kitty actually learned to double tap its paw to activate its favorite game. Just don't blame us if you have to fight your furry friend for the use of your iPad. Now, I don't have a cat, so I am relying on you for reviews. Send me in videos of your cat playing and let me know if you like it. If they like it, you know, the whole you, it thing. Just let me know. Finally, Google Plus still has quite a ways to go before reaching Facebook status. They'll hit the billion user mark this year. But they're still adding users at an impressive rate. 8 months after its initial launch, G Plus has broken the 90 million user mark. At this rate, 625,000 new users a day puts them on pace to crack the 400 million user mark by the end of the year. Don't be late to the party. I seriously love the interactivity I have with you guys on Google Plus. You can find me there, of course, at gplus.to/CallieLewis and on Callie Lewis on Twitter. And thank you guys so much for hanging out with me all day long on social media, on YouTube, and geekbeat.tv, where you can leave comments. I'm Callie Lewis. Bye. Popo, I told you not to do this while we're shooting. Let the bad guys get away. It's more important that we shoot. Yeah,